Let's talk about
loop law.
Remember, loop law is applicable for closed loops only. The algebraic sum of changes in potential around any closed loop involving resistors and cells in the loop is zero. The algebraic sum of changes in potential around any closed loop involving resistors and cells in the loop is zero. While applying this loop law, you must follow certain sign conventions. This loop law is entirely based on law of conservation of energy. Now, let me explain this loop law and junction law by taking a circuit. Let's consider this circuit. So, this circuit consists of two cells and three resistors. Let's name the junctions A, B, C, D, E, and finally F. Now, in the problems of Kirchhoff's law, if the currents, the directions of the currents are given in the problem itself, it's fine. Otherwise, you can imagine the current direction as you like. Only the thing is, suppose if your answer is coming in negative, that means your assumption is just opposite to the real situation. So it is up to you to decide to assume that the currents. Let's consider that I1 is drawn from the first cell and I2 is drawn from the second cell. Now here, this I1 comes here, this I2. So at this junction, this must be I1 plus I2. Where from it has come? Because from the first Kirchhoff's rule, it says that at any junction, the sum of the currents coming towards the junction must be equal to the sum of the currents that are moving away from the junction. Are leaving the junction. So this I1, this I2, they are going in this direction. Therefore, I1 plus I2. Now, we know that if I2 is driven out from the cell, the same current must pass through the negative terminal. Therefore, here, this I1 plus I2 comes here. And this I2 will be passing through this. Therefore, left out is I1. So, first we have applied the Kirchhoff's junction rule. So, we have assumed that I1 current is coming from first cell, I2 from second cell. Therefore, at the junction, I1 plus I2. Now, at this junction, when I1 plus I2 current is there, I2 must be passing through this one because we have drawn I2 from the positive terminal. So therefore from negative terminal I2 must be going through it. So similarly, if I1 plus I2 is the net current and I2 has already gone in this direction, then the left out current is I1 must be reaching to this negative terminal of E1. Now for this, if you want to apply the loop law, so before applying loop law, you must have to follow certain sign conventions. So, what are the sign conventions? Sign conventions means when you have to take positive, when you have to take negative. Now, there are two types of sign conventions. The sign conventions which I am talking here are just as given in your NCERT textbook. In some other textbooks, that they have taken the reverse of the sign convention. You better stick to a particular sign convention and do the problems so that anyway the answers remain same, whatever the sign convention you follow. Okay, in this sign convention, first we have to take a loop. The direction of the loop must be very specific. Suppose if I take a loop A, B, E, F, A. What loop I am considering? A, B, E, F, A. Because I started from A, to get the closed loop, I should end with the A. In this, when we move, in this direction, no elements are there, and then we are turning and we are moving in this direction. So here it is positive, here it is negative. So you are getting the potential drop, positive to negative. That means the potential value is reduced. So therefore, I must consider minus E2. Why should I consider minus E2? Because potential drop took place in the path in which I am moving. Now here, so this is my direction, but the current is coming in the opposite direction. So what is the potential drop here? I2 R2. So this I2 R2 must be with positive. That is, in the direction you are moving, if the currents are coming opposite to you, then it increases the it drops the potential here, so that in this direction it is increased, therefore I2 R2. The simple logic, simple idea is when you are moving, if the currents are in the opposite direction, take plus. When you are moving in the same direction, take negative. Now here, after that we will move here. In this there is no. So here again I1 R1 is the drop. But here now you are also moving in the same direction of the current. Therefore, I must consider negative. And here this is a potential gain because negative and you are moving towards positive. Therefore, I must write plus E2, which is equal to 0. The total change in the total loop, closed loop, in the potential differences must be always equal to 0. I hope you would have followed this one. Let me tell you simply, if in your path, if battery, if you are moving in this direction, so you are going towards negative. That means you are going towards the lower potential. Therefore, minus. If you move in this direction, you are moving in the negative to positive. Therefore, you are gaining the potential. That is plus. It is as simple as that, so far as cells are concerned. Now, potential drops. Suppose if you are moving in this direction, current is also in your direction, then potential drop will take place and that is negative. If the current is in this direction and you are moving in this direction, then it is positive. If you take these two points in mind, then you can do any problem related to Kirchhoff's law. Now let me write the equations for some other loops. Apart from A, B, E, F, A, I can also take B, C, D, E, B. In this, I am starting from B. I am going in this way. No elements are found. So it's good. Now, here the total current is I1 plus I2. And it is passing through R3. Therefore, the potential drop is I1 plus I2 times R3. But you have to decide whether it is positive or negative. The current is in your direction. Therefore, it is negative. Now, after that, here, no element. Then again here, I2, R2, potential drop. Again, it is in your direction only. Therefore, again negative, I2, R2. Now, here, you are in the increasing direction of the potential. Minus 2 plus. Therefore, gaining in potential. So, this must be equal to 0. Now, let's talk about the bigger loop. A, B, C, D, E, F, A. That is the outer loop. So, in this, nothing is there. So, here, minus I1 plus I2 times R3. Why I considered minus? Because I am in the same path. Currents are also following in the same path. Therefore, it is negative. Now, here, that is also negative. I1, R1, this should be R1. I1, R1. I must write capitals. I1, R1. And this is in increasing direction. Plus E1 is equal to 0. So, in these problems, suppose if there are two unknowns, then you must have minimum two equations. If there are three unknowns, then you must have minimum three equations. So, here, first loop, this we have considered, second loop, this, and third loop, this entire. So, with these three equations, you can solve the values of I1 and I2. So, we have to try some numericals and then we should tally the answers. And then if it is there, it's fine. If you are getting the answers, it's fine. Otherwise, you have to study the law once again and again. You have to sit and do it.